Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India. Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 11th of May. Coronavirus cases in India crossed 67,000 after highest daily jump. At least 4 people wounded in back-to-back explosions in Kabul. And Sri Lanka eases restrictions after 7-week lockdown. And now for all the details. Coronavirus cases in India have crossed the 67,000 mark, while death toll has crossed 2,200. With the cases rising despite the nationwide lockdown, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi held crucial meeting with the chief ministers on ways to strengthen the COVID-19 containment strategy and stepping up of economic activities in a collaborated manner. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday chaired a fresh round of consultation with chief ministers on ways to strengthen the COVID-19 containment strategy and stepping up of economic activities in a calibrated manner. The interaction comes days ahead of the scheduled ending of the nationwide lockdown. India's health ministry, in a press briefing on COVID situation in the country, said that with an increase in 4,213 cases in the past 24 hours, India's COVID-19 count reached 67,152 on Monday. The number of active cases in the country rose to 44,029. The number of deaths in the country due to the infection reached 2,206.
Ab tak 20,917 log COVID-19 se cure ho chuke hain. और 44,029 केसेस एक्टिव मेडिकल सुपरविजन में हैं. पिछले 24 घंटे में अगर हम देखें तो पाते हैं कि टोटल केसेस में 4,213 केसेस का इंक्रीज नोट किया गया है, पर साथ में ही 1,559 पेशेंट्स क्योर भी हुए हैं. इस तरीके से हम देखें तो पाते हैं कि हमारा टोटल रिकवरी रेट अब 31.15% हो चुका है.
Meanwhile, India announced a limited reopening of its giant rail network beginning on Tuesday after a nearly 7-week lockdown. The ongoing lockdown, which was imposed to contain the spread of coronavirus, is scheduled to end on May 17. Ahead of railways operations resuming, the railways opened ticket booking online on Monday.
Moving on. European lawmakers, experts and political activists from Pakistan have strongly criticized Islamabad for making full use of world's COVID distraction to silence the dissident voice. They demanded safety and security of political activists and journalists from Pakistan who have taken refuge in parts of Europe and other Western countries.
Members of the European Parliament, experts and political activists from Pakistan strongly criticized Islamabad for making full use of world's COVID distraction to silence the dissentient voice. They demanded safety and security of thousands of political activists and journalists from Pakistan who have taken refuge in parts of Europe and other Western countries while speaking at ARC Human King Conference 2020 virtually from parts of Europe and UK on Friday.
While on the other hand, the Pakistani administration, especially its infamous spy agency, ISI, is making full use of the world's COVID-19 distraction to kill political dissidents, including leaders of the Baloch of Pashtun movement.
The recent killing of a leader of the Pashtun Tahafuz movement, Arif Wazir, in Waziristan, and the discovery of the dead body of missing Baloch journalist Sajid Hussain in Sweden on April 30th have sent a wave of shock in the world, especially in the European continent, that felt the heat of coercive attitude of the Pakistani spy agency amidst coronavirus pandemic.
I urge all Baluch students and activists and journalists abroad to be extra vigilant in their respective countries, because we face a cowardly and immoral enemy, which will not hesitate to do anything.
Baloch leader Mehran Mari, who joined the discussion from London, said that Pakistan's spy agency, the ISI, had trained to target the intellectuals, students and political activists.
In news from Afghanistan, at least four people, including a child, were injured after four back-to-back explosions rocked Afghan capital Kabul on Monday, a police official said. The blasts were caused by roadside bombs planted at an area in Kabul to target the convoy of Afghan security personnel. No group claimed responsibility for the attack till the last reports came in. Afghan government forces in the last 2 months have suffered heavy casualties across the country. The violence poses an immediate threat to a fragile peace deal between the United States and the Taliban, signed in February, as the military is forced to fight an emboldened Taliban with less US support.
گرام بس شد که من پشتر سعی کردم دیدم که من خاکا بود کلش باز شد باسکل ماسکل اونجا ایلا کردم خودم می طرف آمدم تا این موتر چند من زخمی هم بوده کلش آنها گرفتن بردن شفاخانه.
Afghanistan on Monday reported over 4,687 coronavirus cases with at least 122 deaths amid the extended lockdown. The spike in numbers came as 285 new COVID-19 cases were registered from across the country over the past 24 hours.
With 285 new COVID-19 cases reported in past 24 hours, total coronavirus cases in Afghanistan reached to 4,687 mark on Monday. The country's Deputy Minister of Public Health, Dr. Waheed Majroo, on Monday said two people died of the coronavirus in the past 24 hours in Kandahar and Nangarhar province and 16 others have recovered. He informed a limited number of patients have been admitted to the isolation center at Darul Aman Palace for various reasons, including security issues. So far, 122 people have lost their lives due to the novel coronavirus in Afghanistan. To contain the pandemic, the Afghan government has put big cities, including capital Kabul, under quarantine since late March, calling on people to remain at home and is providing them aid. However, in a letdown incident over the weekend, at least six people lost their lives when protesters, angry over what they see as unfair food aid distribution, clashed with police in western Ghor province. The Afghanistan Independent Human Rights Commission, or AIHRC, is looking into the worrying reports of police firing on protesters.
In news from Sri Lanka, businesses, public transportation and government departments gradually reopened on Monday in the Sri Lankan capital Colombo as authorities relaxed coronavirus lockdown, which began in mid-March. The island nation has so far reported over 850 coronavirus cases with 9 associated deaths.
Sri Lankan government from Monday eased the coronavirus lockdown restrictions imposed since mid-March, allowing businesses, public transportation and government departments to reopen. In two districts of Colombo and Gampaha, curfew will be in force until further notice, while in other districts including Kalutara and Puttalam, curfew will be effective only from 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. daily. As restrictions were lifted, general public started heading to work while practicing social distancing and other measures as requested by the authorities.
අපි මාස දෙකක් තිස්සේ මේ වැඩපොළවල් වහලා තිබ්බේ මේ කොරෝනා රෝගියත් එක්ක අපිට රජයේ නිකුත් කරා මේ වැඩපොළවල් අරින්න කියලා. ඉතින් රජයට කියපු ආකාරයට මේ නීති අනුව අපි වැඩපොළ කරගෙන යනවා. පෞගිය කාලේ අපිට ආර්ථික ප්‍රශ්න සෑහෙන්න තිබ්බා. ආර්ථිකය වැටිලා බිස්නස් වැරලා ඉතින් අපිට ගොඩක් සතුටුයි මාස දෙකකට පසුව හරි අපිට මේ ආයතනය කරගෙන වැඩ කරන්න මාර්ගය සලසා දීම ගැන අපිට ගොඩක් සතුටුයි.
Under the new guidelines, government offices and private businesses are permitted to resume operations. However, employers are responsible for judging how many employees may return to the work. The public have been asked to continue to avoid unnecessary travel and gatherings. Those at home are required to remain indoors and only leave for the purchase of essential items such as food and medicine. As of Monday, there have been 856 confirmed COVID-19 cases in Sri Lanka, with 9 associated deaths.
The confirmed cases from COVID-19 surpassed the 15,000 mark in Bangladesh on Monday, as the country recorded the highest single-day cases with 1,034 more people testing positive. This takes the number of total confirmed cases to 15,691.
The number of new COVID-19 infections in Bangladesh rose by 1,034 in the last 24 hours, the health ministry said on Monday. This is the highest daily increase in the country so far, taking the total number of infected cases to 15,691. Senior Health Ministry official Naseema Sultana in a press briefing on Monday said 11 people died with coronavirus infections in the last 24 hours, taking the total fatalities in the country to 239. The total recovery number stands at 2,902 now, and a total of 183 people were put under isolation in the last 24 hours. Meanwhile, amid the nationwide shutdown to contain the spread of COVID-19, Bangladesh's Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina earlier said the government was trying to reopen some sectors gradually so that the poor could earn their livelihoods. Hasina's government had extended the country's coronavirus lockdown for the fourth time to May 16.
Moving on, Nepal on Monday recorded 10 new cases of COVID-19, taking the toll in the country to 120. All the new cases are reported in Nepal's Kapilavastu district.
Nepal's health ministry on Monday confirmed 10 new COVID-19 cases, taking the nationwide count to 120. All of the newly detected cases of the infection have been identified in Kapilvastu district of Nepal's province 5, the health ministry said in a statement. Health condition of the patients, all of them male, aged between 18 to 34 year, was reported to be normal. With the new cases, Kapilvastu district alone hosts 15 cases of the deadly virus despite the ongoing lockdown which started in March. Nepal from Sunday has introduced time card for vehicles to ply on the road, easing the lockdown in capital Kathmandu, which also has been adopted by numerous districts around the nation. Nepal's cabinet meeting last week had decided to let 45 different kinds of industries to operate, abiding strictly with the protection guidelines, further easing the lockdown.
Mass hatchling of olive ridley turtles began at Rishikulya Beach in India's southeastern Odisha province this weekend. Millions of hatchlings came out of the nest buried in sand to crawl towards the sea to start their long journey.
Millions of baby olive ridley turtles made their way out from beaches and into the sea. The numbers are far larger than in previous years, as the coronavirus pandemic has forced many in India to stay home and beaches have been deserted. Rishikulya Beach in India's southeastern Odisha province is known to be one of the few rookeries in the world where the olive ridley turtles come to lay eggs during late winters and beginning of spring every year. The turtles usually come during the night and lay eggs in the sand, but this year there were reports of thousands of turtles coming up onto the beaches during the day. After a period of about 45 days, the hatchlings come out and return to the seas. Experts and authorities estimate that the turtles laid around 60 million eggs in Indian beaches this year.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.